First of all, about this animal sacrifice. Look, this is an outdated idea that some temples still carry on in India, okay? Now, somebody said, you know, one Christian lady was attacking me on BBC television, said, Mr. Lakhani, Hinduism is so bloodthirsty and so horrible, and I know, because I went to a Kali temple in India and they were sacrificing a goat. You are horrible monsters, you sacrifice animals, this is terrible. I said, madam, you don't have to visit a little Kali temple in India to discover that a goat was sacrificed. Go to Bradford, there are 5,000 butchers who are sacrificing animals in the name of God every day. You don't need to visit India for that. So this is an outdated practice and it has been kind of strongly criticized. This is not right. Now Ramakrishna was actually living in a Kali temple in Calcutta. And the temple authorities were carrying out this ritual. Not that he supported it, but he was aware of it. And he did not participate in it, but he was aware of it. It was in the Kali temple. So I'm not saying he supported it or promoted it. No way. It goes against the whole grain of what Ramakrishna stands for. The other thing you said is, did Ramakrishna have similar experiences as Swami Vivekananda? Turn the tables, because in fact, the real story is, this Ramakrishna's spiritual experiences were so comprehensive that one of the greatest thinkers in the Western world, Sir Arnold Toynbee, said, he's an atheist. He said, the spiritual experiences recorded in the story of Sri Ramakrishna is so comprehensive that no other human being in the history of humanity can be equated to that. So you see, he's even prepared to say he's much more kind of had comprehensive experience more than Christ or any other Buddha even. So here is a modern thinker, not me, promoting the idea that Ramakrishna had tremendously comprehensive experience. Mm-hmm. You say, what is that, Mr. Lakhani? Look, in the Hindu tradition, you can think of ultimate reality as a principle, like Atman or Brahman. You can think of the ultimate reality as a personality. Oh, I love Mother Goddess. Oh, I love Vishnu. I love Shiva. You can polarize your ideas about spirituality as a personality and relate to it, or try and experience those personalities. Or you can relate to the idea, deeper idea of principle-oriented Hinduism says your essential nature is spirit, Atman. So there is nobody I know who says, in 1 minute I can experience that I am Atman. Next minute I can say, oh, I see the Mother Goddess. I play with her and dance with her. How can you have both in the same one life? That is why I say most comprehensive, you know, kind of feature about Ramakrishna. Very comprehensive in the level of experience he had. Now, he was, in fact, look, this is not recorded. For example, when we had, say, Chaitanya, when he used to get a glimpse of God or, you know, experience of God, his pores would bleed. Actually, such a dynamic experience, he can't bear it. So in fact, a person, if he's not fit enough, he can't bear this kind of severe spiritual experience for more than a few minutes. He'll bleed to death. So with Ramakrishna, this guy, this is why I love this fellow, I'm in love with this guy. For 24 hours, 7 days a week, he was in a God intoxicated state. You can't stop this guy. And in fact, if you went near him and mentioned the word God or spirit, he will immediately go into deep meditation and topple over. So tremendously kind of all the time tuned, if you like, we're plugged into the idea of spirit. Comprehensive. This is the Ramakrishna. That's why I love him.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism, sponsored by People Care, encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.